Hello everyone, this is Meenakshi Birari, working as an assistant professor in chemistry at Maratha Vidya Prasarak Samaj, Nasik. In today's lecture, I am going to start the second chapter of industrial chemistry, that is sugar and fermentation industry. In this, we will study manufacturing of refined cane sugar from sugar cane. In today's lecture, we will study the few steps involved in the manufacturing of cane sugar from sugar cane, like essential raw materials, harvesting and extraction of juice. In this chapter, we have to study sugar industry and fermentation industry. It includes number of subtopics like occurrence of sugar industry, manufacturing of refined cane sugar from sugar cane, general idea of carbonation and sulfatation processes, their comparison, byproduct and also the uses. Also in the same, we have to study fermentation industry, which includes topics like introduction, importance, basic requirement of fermentation process, manufacture of industrial alcohol from molasses, fruits, food grains and ethylene, manufacturing of wine, beer, whiskey, rum, etc. and also the importance in power alcohol. So all these topics we will study in detail one by one. First of all, let us start first part of this chapter, that is sugar industry. First of all, what is sugar? We know that what we call sugar, the chemist knows as sucrose in the grouping called carbohydrates. And what are carbohydrates? Hydrate the carbon, that means which contains carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. So that compounds are called carbohydrate. The simplest of the sugars is glucose, having molecular formula C6H12O6. Sucrose having molecular formula C12H22O11 is a condensation molecule made up of two glucose molecules, and to make the chemistry work. Sugar industry is the second biggest industry of the country, the first being the textile industry. Cane sugar, that is also known as the sucrose, having molecular formula C12H22O11, is used all over the world as a sweetening agent. And cane sugar, it occurs in sugar cane, beet, maple, sweet sorghum and some species of palm. Many fruits such as pineapple, ripe banana, apricot, etc. also contain the sugar as sucrose. We know that sugar supplies man about 13% the energy required for existence. Industrially, sugar is mainly obtained from sugarcane and beet. In India, most of the sugar is produced from sugarcane. India has been the chief sugar producing country in the world and is an exporter of sugar. So, the word sugar used in everyday life refers to the chemical, that is sucrose, and sucrose therefore occurs in sugar cane and also in sugar beet. Its concentration in lower part of sugar cane is greater than in the upper parts. So, we should remember the sucrose, also called cane sugar, it is also the sugar. When we observe the chemical formula and structure, so glucose plus fructose, there is a formation of sucrose having molecular formula C12H22O11. So sucrose is produced as glucose and fructose are joined together by a condensation reaction. Sucrose is commonly called table sugar. Sucrose therefore occurs in sugarcane and in sugar beet. Its concentration in lower parts of sugarcane is greater than in the upper parts. In India, sucrose is obtained from sugarcane only, and sugarcane it contains 70-75% water, 10-15% crystalline sugar, 0.5% or 1% reducing sugar, 10-18% fiber and 1% ash and organic acids. Simply, chemically, sugar is the substance, that is sucrose, which can be hydrolyzed in acidic solution. So what happens when the hydrolysis of sucrose occurs? Chemically, that sucrose or sugar is the substance which can be hydrolyzed in acidic solution, that is below pH 7, to form the monosaccharides that are glucose and fructose. So monosaccharides, that means having one sugar unit, and glucose and fructose, these are monosaccharides. Sucrose is disaccharide. So sucrose disaccharide undergo the hydrolysis to form two monosaccharide units, one is glucose and second one is fructose. In short, chemically, sugar is the substance which can be hydrolyzed in acidic solution, and it forms two monosaccharides, that are glucose and fructose. We should remember the structure of sucrose. Then further, this one is the structure of glucose, it is the structure of fructose. Glucose and fructose both having the same molecular formula, only they differ in their structures. We should remember that is a 6-membered ring and it is a 5-membered ring. So glucose and fructose both differ in their structural formula, having the same molecular formula, C6H12O6, C6H12O6 for the fructose and glucose. The main source of cane sugar, that is sucrose, is the sugar cane. During 19th century, sucrose became the commercial commodity for the world. Today, the quality of sugar has been improved to a great extent as a result of better techniques which are employed throughout the world. Sugar industry is the second biggest industry of the country. Industrially, sugar mainly obtained from sugarcane and also from the beet. We know that sugar supplies man about 13% the energy required for existence, and in India, most of the sugar is produced from sugarcane. India has been the chief sugar producing country in the world and is an exporter of sugar. So what is the importance of sugar industry? Cane sugar is used all over the world as a sweetening agent. Also, sugar supplies man with about 13% of energy of existence. About half of the world production of sugar is from sugarcane. Also, the byproducts which are obtained from sugar industry are also utilized as a raw material for the number of other industries. So let us see the number of steps involved in the manufacturing and also how the sugar is processed. The initial stage involves sampling, weighing and washing the sugarcane. From there, the material passes to can crushers and then into the mill. The bagasse, which is the byproduct, it results from the milling. It is used in the boilers for steam production, that is used to power the process. The surplus bagasse from this stage is used in industry. Then, what are the steps involved in the manufacture of cane sugar from sugar cane? These are raw material, then extraction of juice, growing and harvesting the cane, cane preparation for milling, milling, clarification, evaporation, crystallization, centrifugation, drying, refining. So these are few steps we have to study in detail one by one, each step involved in the manufacture of cane sugar from sugar cane. First of all, the raw material which are required for the manufacturing of cane sugar from sugar cane. So what are the raw materials? These are sugarcane, water, lime, calcium phosphate, sulfur dioxide gas. These are important raw materials required for the manufacturing. The raw material used in the manufacture of sugar or sucrose, that is sugarcane. It is large perennial tropical grass belonging to the genus Saccharum. It has bamboo-like stalk, grows to a height about 8 to 15 feet and contain 11 to 15% sucrose by weight. The cane stalk is round and it is covered with a hard rind which is light brown, green, yellowish green or purple in color depending upon the variety. Number of varieties are there. Then the stalk consists of a series of joints or internodes separated by nodes. The rind and nodes are woody in nature while internode is soft pith. The internode consists the greater part of the juice containing sucrose. The nodes contain eyes or buds which sprout when planted. So that is overall the information about the sugar cane, and it is nothing but the raw material used in the manufacture of sugar. It is belonging to the genus Saccharum. It has bamboo like stalk and it grows to a height 8 to 15 feet and contains 11 to 15% of sucrose by weight. Then the next step, that is harvesting. Sugarcane is harvested by chopping down the stems but leaving the roots so that it regrows in time for the next crop. Harvest times tend to be during the dry season and the length of the harvest ranges from as little as 2.5 months up to 11 months. So the well-developed sugar canes are cut at ground level and at the same time leaves and top of the stalk are removed. The harvested sugar canes are transported to the sugar mill by the use of trucks, trailers, car tandems or railroad. There should not be any delay in transporting the sugar cane to the factory, otherwise there will be loss in weight as well as inversion to glucose and fructose that passes into molasses. So we should take care, precaution, that there should not be any delay in transporting the sugarcane to the factory. What is the reason? Because there will be loss in the weight as well as inversion to the glucose and fructose which passes into molasses. To avoid this, there should not be any delay in transporting the sugarcane to the factory. Now the next step, that is extraction of juice. The first stage of processing is the extraction of the cane juice. In many factories, the cane is crushed in a series of large roller mills similar to a mangle, which is also known as wringer, which was used to squeeze the water out of clean washing a century ago. The sweet juice comes gushing out and the cane fiber is carried away for use in the boilers. In other factories, a diffuser is used as is described for beet sugar manufacture. Either way, the juice is pretty dirty. The soil from the fields, some small fibers and the green extracts from the plant are all mixed in with the sugar. So harvested sugar cane must be washed with the water before milling to eliminate soil, rocks and field trash. The cane is first washed to remove dirt and mud, then cut diagonal into small pieces by rapidly rotating knives. The cane chips are then sent to milling train consisting of 2 rolled crusher followed by 3 rolled mills. The mill consists of 3 horizontal rollers which are arranged in triangular pattern. only the top roll rotates and the two bottom rollers remains stationary. In this, the cane is first washed to remove dirt and mud. Harvested sugarcane must be washed with the water before milling to eliminate the dirt, soil, rocks, etc. Washing system consisting of conveyors with water jets, baths for removal of stones and stepping rolls. The washed sugarcane is first prepared for grinding by one or more of the different operations like chopping, pressing and crushing. After washing, chopping the sugarcane into smaller pieces with one or two sets of rotating knives having 400 to 600 rpm or crushed into smaller pieces. Then pressing, in that the crushed sugarcane then passes through a series of three horizontal rollers, first mill, arranged in a triangular pattern which is represented in this figure. The top roller rotates counterclockwise while the bottom roller is regulated by hydraulic ramps about 500 tons per square inch. The crusher and first mill are provided with vibrating screens and arrangement for transferring the extracted juice to the raw juice tank. Below each mill, there is a juice pan into which express juice it flows. So here juice pan, perforated juice pan. The crusher and first mill extract about 60 to 70% of the cane juice and the remaining mills take out 20 to 24% cane juice from bagasse, that is from the fiber. The bagasse still containing some juice pass successively through the second, third and fourth mills and then to the storage or to the kiln in which it is used as a fuel to run the mill. So the pressure on the top roller is maintained at 75 to 80 tons per meter of roller length. The cane juice collected in the pan, the raw juice is sent to the boiling house. Below each mill, there is a juice pan into which express juice flows. The crusher and first mill extract about 60 to 70% of the juice and the remaining mills take out 22 to 24% cane juice from bagasse or from the fiber. So that the second, third and fourth mills are provided with simple containers. When the chips are crushed, only about 60 to 70% of juice extracted and the bagasse containing the rest of juice is passed first, second, third, fourth mills. So the compound imbibition technique is used. Hot water is spread on the bagasse passing through third mill. Then the juice from the third mill is spread between first and second mill. The diluted juice from the fourth mill is spread between second and third mill. The moistening of bagasse helps the efficient extraction of the cane juice. So that is the actual process which occurs during the extraction of juice. So it is the milling train, three roll mills, first, second, third. In this way, bagasse or the fiber is removed by crushing and milling process. Now let us see what is compound imbibition technique which is used in this compound imbibition process. It is a process to reduce the sucrose in the bagasse, that is in the fiber, by repeated dilution. So the process in which water or juice is applied to a bagasse to enhance the extraction of juice at the next mill. The term also applied to the fluid which is used for the purpose. Simply, it is a process to reduce the sucrose in the bagasse by repeated dilution. In the fifth mill tandem, water is added to the fourth mill and the expressed juice from that mill is brought back to the second mill. In this way, the juice in the bagasse is always diluted before crushing. Thus, nearly 95 to 99% juice is extracted from spent cane, that is from bagasse. The bagasse which contains unextracted sugar, about 1%, the woody fiber and 40 to 50% water. This usually goes to the boilers as fuel. Many factories purchase this bagasse for making wallboard, paper manufacture, insulating material, hardboard, cattle blending, bedding, etc. There are some types of compound imbibition process. What are these types? Three important types of imbibition. First, simple imbibition. Second, double imbibition. And third, compound imbibition. So what is simple imbibition? Rarely practiced in modern installations, water only is applied to the various mills. Double imbibition, now almost absolute, water is applied to the bagasse from the next to last two mills and combined thin juice from the last two mills is returned to the earlier mills in the train. And the compound imbibition, it is applicable to trains of four or more mills. Here, water is applied to bagasse going to the last mill. The last mill juice is returned to bagasse going to the last mill. This juice in turn goes back to bagasse from the preceding mill and so on. That means it is a process to reduce the sucrose in the bagasse by repeated dilution. In this way, the juice in the bagasse is always diluted before crushing. Nearly 95 to 99% juice is extracted from the spent cane, from the fiber. So, in today's lecture, we have studied occurrence and importance of sugar industry. Also, some steps involved in the manufacture of cane sugar from sugar cane, like raw materials, extraction of juice, harvesting of the sugar cane, etc. In next lecture, we will study the remaining steps involved in the manufacture of cane sugar from sugar cane. Thank you.